Never.
You ain't never had a friend like me.
Believe that.
Cause you ain't never had a friend like me. See, at night I watch the sky, I take another breath, I smoke my new boy to the butt like it's the last motherfucker left. Just me and you evading enemies, let you get my last shot of Hennessy.
Hi guys, welcome to my video, my channel, whatever. Today we have a special guest. Introduce yourself.
Andrea.
This is my
grandma
and my friend, sometimes. So this is a different type of video. Today we're going to be talking about caretakers, for people who have mental health issues, who have been diagnosed with mental health, all that stuff, what it's like to live with them. If you guys like this video, we will do a whole series on it because we have a lot to talk about, right?
Yes.
Okay. Her eyes are open. Don't worry. They don't look open. Okay, so we're gonna start with some questions. Okay, how long have you taken care of this individual?
For the past 39 years, you could say. He's 39 now.
Okay, how does it feel to live with someone who has mental health issues?
Oh God, it's very hard. Lots of work, patience if you don't have it. Learning how to let things go, just work with it. It's hard.
How do other people react to situations?
Certainly not like I do. Anything the person that is having those mental problems can cause a lot of hectic havoc around you and your house. But you always gotta understand they're different than the normal person because they have mental health problems.
How do you react to situations?
Well, I first get like angry, but then I'll argue back and forth, but then I say, you know what? Better just be quiet and wait till the storm is over. But then you have to deal with the consequences of what happened during the storm.
Great answers. Okay. How do you deal with their feelings?
Their feeling?
Yeah, like how do you help them deal with it?
I try to show a lot of love, give a lot of love, a lot of understanding, patience, explain to them that there's times where you can't do these things and you need to really think before you do them, but when they're in a crisis mode, they're not hearing you.
How is their mindset?
Well, usually experienced with my son, his feelings are always mixed, up and down all the time.
Okay, how is your mindset? Wait, did I say feelings? Mindset, yeah, how
is
your mindset?
Well, mindset is incorrectly, always has been. A lot of people don't agree with, you know, because they say, oh, that's why he's like that, because you let him get away with everything. It's not about letting them get away with anything. It's that they live a daily struggle. So I think my mindset, I learn a lot.
It hit the point. Okay, I think that's up louder. Because the heater. Ready? How is their living situation? Like, how do they go, like, they wake up in the morning? How is their day?
Well, depends. If there was no nightmare, if there was no drama the day before, if he's not worried about something, he'll wake up good. But then if he didn't sleep correctly, he's had a nightmare, or someone said something that bothered him, he'll wake up in the most foulest of moods. And not being on the medication. Foul mood.
Okay, how do families treat them?
Not everyone treats them the same. Think he's just acting up. Something he says that he uses as an excuse. But if they really sat down to talk to him and understand who he is and how he is, they might get a different idea of him.
Yeah, like that saying, if you sat down with me and had one deep conversation on why I was the way I was,
yes, Yes.
You would have a different
opinion.
Mindset,
yes.
Point of view. Okay. How do other people treat them? Like strangers, police officers,
oh God,
medical people.
Don't even talk to me about the police. They don't get it.
Guys, that is a story time. If you guys want that story time, let us know. We will tell you the whole tea.
And not everybody treats them the same, especially sometimes in the healthcare, not everybody's compassionate, from what I've noticed. And then there's some that love their job and they can really reach a person that needs that help to get them to open up and talk about their lives and what happens.
Okay, how do they treat themselves?
Well, from my experience of mine, always wants to please everyone else before themselves. Always want to help, always demonstrates a lot of love, and he talks a lot, he talks loud, so people don't like it, but that's who he is. It's okay. That's the way they are. That's who they are.
Okay. How do you help them?
Well, most of the time I'll tell this one to sit down for a few minutes, take it easy, don't talk so loud because people think you're yelling. Try to give him advice and opinion on how to change some things in himself for other people to say, oh, you know what, this guy ain't that bad after all.
Okay, do you think medication helps them a lot, a little bit? There's no change? Do you see a big difference?
Oh my God, I see a major difference. When the medication is taken every day without missing a day, it's like a whole other person. Quiet, slow voice, talkative. You know, they're watching the TV. It's the longest time I've ever seen them sitting. It's great.
Okay. So, next question. What were they diagnosed with?
Bipolar disorder, PTSD, and depression.
What were the times? Were there times you felt things would never get better?
Yes, over the years, I was like, Jesus, are we always on the same page, same time? It's like the page or the channel doesn't change, and it's like a merry-go-round that doesn't stop.
Do you wish people had more knowledge?
Yes, how to understand the illness that they get. You should really read up on it and listen to everything that's helpful to help them to be better for themselves.
Did their childhood affect their mental health?
Yes, depends on what happens to you. That's how you develop these things, because you go through some horrible things as children. That's the sad part, that kids have to live this. It's not easy. It's terrible.
Are they open about their feelings?
Mine is. There's nothing he hasn't done that I don't know about. It comes easy to him to do. In my case.
Do they live in denial?
Yes, especially when it's time to take those medications. I don't need it. I'm better. I can do this. I haven't had a dream, or I haven't been through that. But it's like one person told me, it's like a car running without oil. That is how their brain works. It's constantly going. But you must stay on those meds, because denial is great. Face it, I need these for the rest of my life. Unless you go to therapy, some people get cured. Who knows? The mind is tricky to me.
Should they have a good support system?
Yes. How important it is to have family, friends if you have them, to help you in the time that your loved one is going through a crisis or something in his life or their life they don't like. Jesus, they could get terrible, especially with the depressing. It's horrible. The anger outbursts where they start throwing things and breaking everything in their room. And until they get that anger out, and it's like nothing happened.
Okay, I just thought about a good question. I need my reading glasses, but I thought about a good question. Oh, have they ever sabotaged or messed up relationships with friends, significant others?
Yes. Depends on the moment, what is happening, because they really hate rejection. Fear of rejection is great for them. Feeling like nobody wants them around, and it's like, oh, that's why they're always trying to please everyone so that you like them, but there's no need for that. They'll like you and love you for who and what you are. Just show them the real you. That's all. And learn that that person lives with different ideas than us.
Are they caring people?
Mine is. When he's good, he's on his meds, everything is working out for him in his life, he could be the best.
I agree.
The best.
I agree. Do they need constant reassurance?
Yes, because they always say nobody loves them, nobody cares about us, nobody worries about us, nobody calls a checkup on me. That means they could care less, but that's not how it is.
Should we wait? Should we raise more awareness?
Yes. Yes, how to learn how to read and understand bipolar, PTSD, depression, schizophrenia. Those people, they do suffer a lot on a daily.
Do they have mood swings?
Oh my goodness. I don't know which one's worse, and I don't know which one's best. But mood swings are terrible.
Do people or things often antagonize them?
Not all the time. Depends on what it is. That might trigger something in their own memory they went through, and then they see or hear or know something, and that sets them back to that moment. And that's like, you can't get them out of that moment till they're out of that moment on their own. Because I've seen it happen.
Should jails and police officers be more aware and how to work with people with mental health?
Oh yeah, they have to be a little bit more friendlier. Would be nice by the police when they come upon you and they write it, and you're explaining like a million ways that they have a mental problem, and it's like one ear out the other. There's a way to treat them to get them to come to your side and calm everything down. Don't escalate, de-escalate.
I agree. Did you learn how to care for him over the years, and was it hard?
Yes, very hard. Because every time you try to show a kindness, or here, look, I bought you something, or here, I gave you something, they get like, it's weird.
And
like,
overwhelmed.
Yeah, like, no, why are they giving me this? Why are you doing that? It's like they feel like they don't deserve nothing. And that's natural.
Do you live in fear?
No, I'm not afraid. Of what? If they was going to hurt me, I would have been hurt by now, in my opinion. No, I'm not afraid of fear in my life to be killed or nothing like that, no.
Are you scared? Like, has there ever been a situation where you have been scared and you think that you are in danger or other people are in danger?
Not that they're in danger, but afraid when they fight with you know, among your own family, like their siblings or whatever, you know, there's a situation, argument, they get into a fight. Sure, I get scared because we don't know what could happen. Just as much as fast as he could do something, so could the person who doesn't have mental health problems.
I agree with that.
It's all about the moment of that anger or what happened. So I always tell this one, always think of the consequence before you do things. I always tell him, I always say it, and somehow, thank God, it got stuck in it. He always says it now. I thought of the consequence right away, so I won't do something. Good. That means I'm getting in there somewhere. Sure do worry about that.
Is it a roller coaster with them?
Yes, because their mind is a roller coaster. A 24-hour one, if you ask me. Especially when they're off their meds. Jesus. Don't ever get off your meds.
Is there anything to fear? Do you think he throws fear into the world? Do you think that when he goes outside, people should be in fear?
In fear of him, no. I'm always scared somebody's going to start something with him. Or if he might, sometimes they forget things. Where is he going? Where is he?
Like a blackout.
Yeah. So, that has always been a fear.
Do they make decisions like a regular person?
No. Not all the time. Sometimes they could do the most worst mistakes. It depends on who they're hanging around with, if there's people around them giving bad advice or opinion or doing bad things. Yes, that should never be.
I don't know if that was me or
that was him.
I was going to say, wow. Are you able to control him when he acts out or is in a panic state, worried?
It depends of what's happening at that moment. If it's like a big argument or a big fight and they really believe what they're thinking and saying, it's hard to calm them down. You have to wait till the explosion is over on their own. And it's so hard to calm them down. Hard, but you can do it because it has worked.
Is there anything you would like to talk about that we haven't, or any questions that you have that I didn't think of?
Just that I wish people would understand that people with these disorders of bipolar, PTSD, depression, ain't no joke. They suffer on a daily, especially once they're off their meds. It's terrible. But when they're on it, they're a whole other person, you could say. But there's nothing they wouldn't help you with. And I wish family and friends would take their time to sit down and speak to someone with these issues and see who they really are, how they really think, and what they wonder, what they would like to see different for themselves, as well as anybody else out there with mental illness. And to be accepted, most of all, to be accepted, like, you know, they're just different. But you gotta learn how to love that different. That's it.
Okay. Thank you, Mrs.
Flores.
Miss Flores, Miss. She's not Mrs. no more. We appreciate you for being on the show. Who do I think I am? Okay, well, if you guys would like to know or hear more different types of topics, some we would have in mind would be like, would you like to hear about any police incidents? We have some good ones. We have a good one. Understanding their mindset, how the caretaker lives, and any crazy stories we might have. If you guys like this video and want to see more, let me know so we can make another video. And hope you guys like it. Thank you guys for watching.
Thank you so much.
Have a nice day. Stay safe. Wash your hands. Cough in your bye. Thank you for watching.
Only God can judge me.
That right?
Only God, baby. Nobody else.
Nobody else.
All you other motherfuckers, get out of my business.